This video is sponsored by VALOI. Hello and welcome to Analog Anonymous. Who wants to start today? Yes.
Hi, everybody. I'm Karin.
Hi, Karin.
Hello.
Hi, Karin.
Yes,
nice to meet you.
Well, I just have to say it. I used a flatbed scanner for years.
Oh no, poor girl.
Yeah,
oh,
and
dear.
I know. It wasn't good for me. It just, the time it took to scan my film and this scanning sound was just too much. And I decided I quit.
That's great. Awesome.
Good work.
Okay. Thank you. Nonetheless, it feels so intimidating and I don't really know where to start. And I guess, that's why I'm here.
That's a good start. You won't regret it.
Yeah. That sounds familiar.
Thank you for opening up, Karin. And no worries, you came to the right video. I mean help group for that. If anything from this intro sounds familiar to you, you came to the right video, because in this video we will talk about camera scanning, but not in the way that you might think. Instead of the classic way of camera scanning using film holders, today I would like to talk about a little revolution to the film scanning world, at least in my opinion, and it is this little device here called the VALOI Easy35 that I've been using pretty extensively over the last month. After having years of experience with flatbed scanning and also switching to camera scanning around 1.5 years ago, I can certainly say that for 35mm film, this little device here is the most fun, the most efficient, and also the fastest way compared to anything I've used before. As a quick disclaimer, this video is sponsored by VALOI and they have also provided me with the scanning equipment that you will see in this video, namely the VALOI Easy35, but also the VALOI 360 Professional Scanning Kit alongside the Essential Copy Stand. However, everything that I will say in this video is my own and honest opinion, and VALOI had no say in the content of this video. On top of that, VALOI has also provided me with a discount code for you, so if any of the VALOI products that you will see in this video today are of interest to you, you can get 10% off your purchase by using the link in the description box. But now let's talk about camera scanning. If you've ever stumbled upon the term camera scanning before, this is probably the type of setup you have seen before. A camera with a macro lens attached to a tripod or a copy stand, with film holders on a light source advancing your film with these types of rollers. Here, for example, I use the VALOI 360 Professional, which is a modular system you can extend with your growing needs. The Professional kit includes film holders for 35mm and 120 film, and after using cheaper plastic film holders in the past, the VALOI 360 system was a pure joy to use, with a high build quality, smooth advancing mechanism, and modularity for different film formats. And as much as I love these film holders in particular, the style of film scanning, using film holders in the first place, has one big downside. Because the scanning itself doesn't take much time, but getting to the point where you can start scanning, setting everything up and aligning everything perfectly is pretty time-consuming and sometimes also nerve-wracking. Besides the film holders, you need some sort of mounting option for your camera, be it a tripod or a copy stand, and with that you need to determine the right kind of distance to your film and also find the right balance, the right angle to have a parallel plane to your film, and on top of that also block out all type of light to not have any stray light in your image, which can be pretty time consuming. If you have a dedicated spot where you can leave your setup as it is, it's maybe not such a big deal. But if you need to assemble and reassemble everything every time when you want to have a scanning session, it can be pretty annoying, to say the least. In my opinion, this little box here solves all these issues, because with the Easy35 you don't have to bother about distances or about angles anymore, you don't have to get an external light source anymore, and you also don't have to black out your entire room just to get ideal results. So this thing is pretty capable, and even though it looks like a fun gimmick for newbies, I think it's a real game changer when it comes to 35mm scanning. But before saying anything else, let me show you some of the results I got by using the Easy35 for scanning. In all honesty, when VALOI approached me and asked if I would like to try out their Easy35 for scanning, I was not particularly convinced right from the start and I wanted to try out their 360 kit instead. However, I am super, super happy that they sent me the Easy35 anyway, because after using it for a month, I can certainly say that all my skepticism was proven wrong and that I can now say that this thing is definitely one of the best pieces of equipment that came out for film photography in the last years. In my opinion, this device truly revolutionizes the idea of camera scanning, and here is the reason why. First off, the Easy35 comes with this base that has an integrated light panel so that you don't need to get one separately. And second of all, instead of having a whole setup with a copy stand or a tripod, this device lets you directly connect your camera to the scanning box by using extension tubes, which means that the cumbersome alignment and positioning is history. And as with a regular camera scanning setup, you need to attach your digital camera, take photos of your negatives, and convert the negatives into positive images by using a dedicated software, which are all steps we will talk about as we go. Fresh out of the box, you will get the Easy35 head itself, which already has the standard 35mm negative holder inside. You will also get a variety of different extension tubes and step-up rings delivered in the kit. So the only thing you need to do before getting started is to get the right step-up ring for the filter thread size of your lens. In my case, it's the 55-62 one, and find out what combination of extension tubes you will need for your setup. The amount or the length of extension tubes depends on your sensor size and the focal length, so you need to find that out by trial and error. For me, for example, one of the long and one of the medium-sized tubes is perfect to get the whole negative in focus with only a thin border around the image. And once you have determined the length of extension tubes that you will need for your specific setup, that is actually the only time that you will have to fiddle around with distances, because after that you can just use this every time and don't have to trial and error as with regular film holders. So the extension tubes will form the kind of perfect spacing and also light-tight area between your camera and your negative. By default, it comes with the regular 35mm holder, but there's also a sprocket holder available if you want to have a bit more of the film border in the frame. Also a slide holder for your mounted slides, as well as holders for APS, 110, 126 and Minox film. You can easily swap out the holder by loosening the screw and sliding the holder out, just make sure to not over tighten the screw afterwards. What I particularly like about this holder is that it's not just straight, but has a subtle S-curve, which brings a slight tension to the film, keeping it straight, and which also helps to get curly film perfectly flat. So for scanning, all you need to do is assemble the kit by attaching the right amount of extension tubes to your lens, turn the light on in the back, turn on your camera, insert your film, and you are ready to go. A couple of notes, the Easy35 has adjustable light strength and also color temperature, and I usually keep it around the middle for both options if I just scan regular 35mm film, but it's good to have the option to tweak that in case you have negatives that are maybe too warm or too cold. On top of that, the Easy35 can be charged via USB-C, which I found very helpful, especially because you can still use it while it's charging. Because for a person like me, my special skill is that I always forget to charge my devices before I want to use them, and usually I have to wait until it's fully charged. So for a person like me, this device is perfect that you can still operate it while it's charging. Also, camera scanning is notorious for attracting dust. With a flatbed scanner, the software usually comes with a way to get rid of your dust straight away, which is not the case when using a camera. So with any camera scanning method, this one included, it's extra crucial to wear gloves and have a dust blower at hand. The duster accessory for the Easy35 that you can attach on the side here definitely helps a lot to keep your negatives clean. Another thing, while the extension tubes and the step-up rings are made out of metal with an anodized matte finish, the Easy35 body itself is 3D printed and made out of plastic. I am usually not the biggest fan of plastic and also wish this one was made out of metal, however it doesn't feel like cheap plastic by any means, but this unit is in fact made out of nylon 12, which makes it very robust and durable. The Easy35 here in Europe costs around 229 euros including taxes, and the duster, which I highly recommend, costs an additional 45 euros. Depending on what you compare it to, it might either be a lot of money or not so much compared to other options. For me personally, I think it's a pretty fair price. price, even though it's not particularly cheap, especially if you take into account that you won't need to buy anything else. You don't need to buy a tripod or a copy stand or a light source, but you have an all-in-one solution if you buy this kit. But wait, I think I might have been a little bit too fast here, because there are two things that we will need, but that you will need with every type of setup, because the VALOI 35 is still a camera scanning setup, self-evidently you will still need a camera and a lens. When it comes to the camera, I think in the digital world today, every camera is more than enough, and every camera can squeeze out enough information for camera scanning, in my opinion. But yeah, just use what you have, be it a mirrorless or also a DSLR camera. I just use the camera I already own, which is the camera that I usually use to film my videos, which is the Fujifilm XS20, which has a 26.1 megapixel APS-C sensor. Of course, the bigger the sensor, the better the quality, and a bigger megapixel count might also squeeze out a little bit more information, but in my opinion, this is plenty, plenty of resolution you have here, and I've never missed any quality when it comes to my film scans I got from this camera. And the other thing that you will need is a macro lens, because you want to get as close to your negative as possible to have it cover the entire frame. So my advice would be to really get a proper macro lens for your system, and you can either get a modern macro lens for your camera, but you could also do what I did and just get an old vintage macro lens. I, for example, got a Minolta 50mm 3.5 MD lens, I think it's called, and so far I've been pretty happy with the results. And next, let's talk about settings. And no matter if you use the classic way of camera scanning or if you use the Easy35, the camera scanning settings are usually always the same, and the first and most important thing is to find your focus. And for that, I usually open up the lens all the way, set my camera to manual focusing, activate focus peaking, and focus the camera on the grain or on a subject in the frame that is well visible. After that, I will stop down my lens again, and my lens, for example, has the best performance and best center to corner sharpness at f8, which is why I step it down to f8. Also, every camera has a base ISO setting, which means that there is an ISO value that introduces the least grain and noise into the images for the cleanest results. With the XS20, for example, the base ISO is 125, which is the ISO I am using for scanning. Then I am going the easy route and adjust my camera to auto shutter speed so that it adjusts the scene to the images on the negative. To be sure to not overexpose and lose any detail, I usually set my camera to either zero or something like minus 1/3 exposure compensation. And last but not least, to avoid any camera shake, I put the 2-second timer on so that the camera takes the picture when my finger is no longer touching the camera. And with this setup, scanning an entire roll literally only takes me around 2 minutes, which is a true game changer for me. There's always plenty of ways to get to a specific destination. And with film conversion as well, there's usually plenty of ways to get your negatives converted into a positive. But here in this video, I will only cover one way, and that is the way that I use and that I have found to give me the best results. And for that, I use Negative Lab Pro, which is a plugin for Lightroom Classic, which means that you will need access to the Adobe Creative Cloud in order to use the plugin. After importing my images from my SD card to my computer, I import them into Lightroom Classic. With black and white images, there isn't really anything you need to do in preparation, but with color negative film, you need to set the white balance on a piece of the film border so that the program can do a correct job in calculating the values for the conversion. Then you can do a batch conversion by selecting all the images from the roll, go to File, plug in Extras, and select Negative Lab Pro. Here you have different options that you can set to your own individual taste. For black and white film, just make sure to select black and white here, but for color negatives, you can try which look suits your work the best. I usually just stick to the frontier setting because it looks a bit like a proper lab scan. Also, what I see a lot of people do is that they crop out the film border before opening up Negative Lab Pro, because Negative Lab Pro operates the best when you only have the image without any borders interfering. However, that step is not really necessary, as you can actually calculate in a border buffer in Negative Lab Pro directly, as for example I do here with 5%, so that NLP will not take the outer 5% of the image into account when doing the conversion. And after NLP has calculated the conversion, you can do some more tweaks here. Usually I leave it at lab standard, but for very contrasty images I sometimes switch to linear flat to get more of the details out. Oftentimes, I already like the results straight as they are, but my goal is to get a distinguished yet rather flat scan that retains a lot of details so that I can later fine-tune it in post. So what I oftentimes do is bring the highlights down and increase the shadows a little bit. And once I am happy with the images, I apply the conversion and export the images as TIFFs to later work on them in Lightroom, crop out the borders, make some minor color adjustment, edit out the dust, and so on. So I was really curious to see a direct comparison between the scanning options. So here I will compare the flatbed scanner, namely the Epson V500, to the classic form of camera scanning, namely film holders, in this case the VALOI 360 kit, to the more modern way of camera scanning by using the VALOI 35. And with the Epson, I used ViewScan to digitize the image as a negative, as a DNG file to be precise, and I converted all three types of negatives with Negative Lab Pro using the exact same settings. As expected, the two camera scanning options with the Easy35 and 360 look pretty similar, almost identical. But what is really surprising to see is how muddy and soft the Epson looks in comparison to the two camera scanning options. And of course, the question of the questions is, which camera scanning setup shall you go for? Which camera scanning setup is actually better? And let me say that this question cannot be answered universally, but it all depends on your specific priorities and your specific needs. So there isn't one system that is better than the other, but there's only one system that might maybe be better suited for you in your specific situation. The number one distinction to factor in is, what film formats do you mainly shoot? If you mainly shoot 35mm film, in my opinion, it's a no-brainer, and the Easy35 is the fastest and least complicated way for that. You won't need to buy an extra copy stand, you won't need to buy an extra light source, and you don't need to black out your room when scanning to avoid stray light. In fact, you can also continue to watch YouTube videos while scanning your film, which before, at least for me, wasn't really possible. You could potentially also grab your camera and run around and scan on the go. Don't do that, it's too shaky, but you get the idea. The Easy35 is very portable and not as disruptive, but you can just scan in the environment that you are in right now and you don't have to change anything to start scanning. The only reason, in my opinion, to go for the classic film holder setup is if you shoot a lot of medium format film, since the Easy35 only lets you scan in 35mm and smaller but not bigger formats. So if you shoot a lot of different formats and want to have one module for everything, the Easy35 might not be the right thing for you. Another thing worth discussing is, if you already have some sort of camera scanning setup at home, let's say some sort of film holders and you use a tripod, then I think it's very debatable if the Easy35 is really worth the upgrade for you. Because the Easy35 will not give you any upgraded image quality or sharpness or whatsoever. The only benefit of the Easy35, in my opinion, is the speed and the comfort and convenience. And you just have to take into account that if you want to invest in that and you already have something to scan, you don't invest in better quality, you just invest in a better user experience. Well, throughout my film journey, I've tried several different methods of scanning. The flatbed scanner, camera scanning with cheap plasticky holders, high quality holders, and also phone scanning. I've done it all, and across the board I can say, I don't particularly like film scanning. Of all of the parts, film scanning is probably the part that I actually like the least, and probably this will never change. Scanning my film will never be my favorite part of photography, but no joke, ever since getting the Easy35, I don't dread film scanning as much anymore. I actually even like it a little bit, which is a big compliment coming from a film scanning procrastinator like me. Ever since getting the Easy35, I haven't used anything else to scan in my 35mm film. I've just used this simply because it's the least complicated, it's the easiest and most convenient thing that requires the least preparation. And that being said, I would say thank you so much for watching. As you can see, it's already getting dark here, so I think it's time to call it a day. Stay strong scanning in your film. Keep it up. And to VALOI, if you could make this in 1:22, this would be an absolute dream. So once again, thanks so much for watching and see you in the next one.